interesting and very important topic, development of atria. So our first topic is development of right atrium. For the development of the right atrium, we will draw one diagram, and this will be, once again, as I always refer, this is a common diagram. Now here, where both the atria as well as ventricles are seen in this diagram. This is a generalized diagram. Now, to darken this dorsal wall of the primitive atrial chamber, what I am darkening is the dorsal wall of the primitive atrial chamber, and this is the entire common ventricular cavity. Now, what we have seen is the right and the left venous valve in the opening of the sinus venosus. So therefore here, septum spurium, this was septum spurium, and this was the right and this was the left venous valve, and here this was sinus septum, this segment, and this was septum spurium. Now here, septum, first of all, there will be the presence of, if I draw here, complete this diagram, septum intermedium. This will be the septum intermedium that we have seen in the last lecture. Now, interatrial septum. Just as interatrial septum have developed, and that interatrial septum which has developed, we will draw it in this way, septum primum. We have seen in the last lecture, this will be septum primum, and overlapping it will be septum secundum. So this structure will be septum secundum. Now, septum secundum is developed from, as we have seen in the last lecture, this septum secundum is developed from, number one, portion of the left venous valve plus syphelic end of the septum primum that we have seen in the last segment, in the last interatrial septum. Now, therefore, this left venous valve is consumed in development of the septum secundum. And what are these venous valves, right and left? They are the opening of sinus venosus. Therefore, now we start from here that after the development of interatrial septum, the portion which is left is the right venous valve, septum spurium, and sinus septum. These three are left. Therefore, now, this much I want to magnify on this side. I will magnify, please come on this side. This will be septum spurium, this will be the right venous valve, and this will be sinus septum. So therefore, I will mark it as here, septum spurium, this will be the right venous valve, and here this will be sinus septum. What will happen is, this is just a magnification of that diagram. Now in the right venous valve, there will be division of this entire right venous valve into three segments by two subendocardial muscular bands. Those subendocardial muscular bands will be, number one, see here, this is upper limbic band, number two, lower limbic band. These are the two subendocardial muscular bands. So therefore, here, we will name this as upper limbic band, and this one will be lower limbic band. This is the first structure to develop in the right venous valve. Please note down. This is the magnified portion of the right venous valve. So, upper and lower limbic bands, they are the subendocardial bands. These are the structures which will divide the entire right venous valve into three zones. Upper zone, middle zone, lower zone. Now, note down, this upper limbic band will always develop initially in between two major openings. Which are those two major openings? Those two major openings will be, number one, the opening of, I will use violet color here, the opening of the superior vena cava. So here, superior vena cava opening. This is in the dorsal wall of the right horn of sinus venosus, which will develop into the posterior part of the right atrium. So superior vena cava opening. And here, there will be opening of inferior vena cava. So therefore, upper limbic band will develop between the opening of superior and inferior vena cava. Lower limbic band will also develop between two openings. Which two openings? Number one, inferior vena cava, and number two, here there will be another small opening which will be known as the coronary sinus. Therefore, now this coronary sinus opening will fuse with the sinus septum. So now, very clearly, these three openings are there, where in the primitive atrial chamber, on which side? Right side. Note down, the right side. Development of upper limbic band between superior vena cava and inferior vena cava openings in the right side. Development of lower limbic band in between opening of inferior vena cava and opening of coronary sinus. And we know that coronary sinus has developed from, previously I have discussed in the previous segments, it will develop from the body plus left horn of sinus venosus. So the entire body of sinus venosus and left horn of sinus venosus will develop into coronary sinus. Now what will happen? Now our entire right atrium will develop from all these sources. What will be the development of right atrium? Please note down. Now see, upper part of the right venous valve, where my hand is there, above the superior limbic band, this much portion. So upper part of the right venous valve plus septum spurium will develop into crista terminalis. So here, I will draw the crista terminalis at this point. Now here, I will rub this structure and I will draw the crista terminalis. So let me draw here. This will be the crista terminalis. Let me name this as crista terminalis. How it has developed? By upper part of the right venous valve along with septum spurium will develop into crista terminalis. Second portion, if we come on this side, can come on this side. Intermediate part of the right venous valve, where my hand is there, in between upper and lower limbic band. This intermediate part of the right venous valve, along with the sinus septum and lower limbic band, along with the sinus septum and the lower limbic band, please note down, will develop into valve of inferior vena cava. So therefore, I will draw here, this will be the valve of inferior vena cava. So let me write here, the valve of inferior vena cava. How this has developed? So for that, I will mention here, the intermediate part of the right venous valve plus sinus septum. This will lead to development of the valve of inferior vena cava. How crista terminalis has developed? That also we will note down. Here, I will write down the septum spurium plus upper part of the right venous valve. Please note down. This will lead to development of crista terminalis. Here, intermediate part of the right venous valve plus sinus septum will develop into valve of inferior vena cava. Now, please come on this side. Lowermost part of the right venous valve. The lowermost part of the right venous valve. This much part of the right venous valve will lead to development of valve of coronary sinus. Not coronary sinus, but the valve of coronary sinus. Because the entire body of coronary sinus will develop from sinus venosus body plus left horn of sinus venosus. This is the valve which I am talking about. The valve of coronary sinus from the lower part of the right venous valve, caudal part of the right venous valve. Please come on this side. Therefore, here I will draw a very small coronary sinus, and this is the valve. I will write down valve of coronary sinus. And how does it develop? This valve of coronary sinus will develop from the most caudal segment of right venous valve. And please note down, what is this right venous valve we are talking about? Once again, I'm going to explain. The right and left venous valves are the channel connecting sinoatrial orifice. The left venous valve was contributing in the development of the septum secundum. The right venous valve has modified into all these three structures. Therefore, now the final, the entire right atrium will develop from three different points. The entire right atrium will develop from three different points. Point number one, please note down, the smooth posterior part, or it is called sinus venarum. So sinus venarum, or the smooth posterior wall of right atrium, will again be divided into portion in front of crista terminalis and portion behind the crista terminalis. So therefore, in the sinus venarum here, the portion which is behind the crista terminalis, and which is the portion behind the crista terminalis? The entire right horn of sinus venosus. So the right horn of sinus venosus is absorbed, is differentiated, is developed into the sinus venarum. Which portion of sinus venarum of right atrium? Behind the crista terminalis. Please note down, very important. So the portion of right atrium which is a part of sinus venarum. What is sinus venarum? The smooth posterior wall of right atrium, which is behind the crista terminalis, will develop from the right horn of sinus venosus. Behind the crista terminalis, from right horn of sinus venosus. I think in next segment now.